We are here for the Spring Sports Banquet. This year, they're combining the Winter Sports Banquet with the Spring Sports Banquet. So we have a lot of teams. I'm Brian DeStute here with Joe Pransky, who is back after playing baseball. He's here tonight with his team as well. So start off, Joe, congrats on a good year, making the tournament, your final year. We have a lot of coaches to talk to tonight. Mr. Gifford, boys basketball coach, talk to Coach Walsh from the boys baseball team, and Coach Gallagher from the girls softball team. A lot of different stuff to talk to. Should be a fun night. I know Joe, you're excited to hang out with your team and everything tonight, so it'll be really good. So we got a lot coming up, and stay tuned. All right, we're here with Coach Gifford, boys basketball coach. Took a while to get here because it's the winter and spring sports banquet. But just to start off, what did you think of your team's success this year?
I thought we had a great year. I mean, we went 16-4 regular season. We split with Bishop Conley. They had beaten us pretty good the 2 years private. It would have been nice to split with Westport, but they beat us twice. But both games were close. We didn't lose any games by more than a couple of points. And then we beat Upper Cape in the first state tournament game, played very, very well. And then we drew Cash from Boston, and we had a chance to beat them, but we didn't make enough free throws down the stretch and had too many kids foul out.
What did you think of the group of seniors that you had this year that are now graduating that you got to work with since JV?
They've been through a lot, Some of them were with me as JV coach, and then 3 years with my varsity. And we went through the JV season. We played, we won more than we lost in that. But the two years previous to varsity, we didn't win a lot of games. And a year ago, we played as tough a schedule as any, East Bridgewater and Norwell and Westport went to the South Sectionals. And the schedule we played was as hard a schedule, I think, as any Holbrook team's ever played.
Were there any specific seniors on the team that you saw, have a real exponential growth from when you first had them to the end?
I think they all improved. We work hard every day, and so I'm not going to single anybody out. It's the group of seniors. They're with me for 3 or 4 years. There was 5 of them. They all worked very, very hard, and I think they all improved over the stretch. And obviously, it was a good way for them to close off their careers.
Right. Do you have any memory? I know this is a goofy one. Do you have any memories with those guys, through coaching them or having them in class that, will give you a good memory of them as they graduate?
I mean, I have great memories. It's that I know that they know me, and it's coming to practice every day and working hard. And that's what we did. And that's why we get better. It's no days off. Practices is as hard as games. And it's just a collective memory that they were a great bunch of kids. They worked very, very hard and had a great senior year. And I'm happy for them that they did.
And last question for you. How do you feel the future of the team? There was some young guys that got significant minutes last year. What do you look forward to for the future?
We're bringing back, I think, our backcourt will be as good as anybody in Division IV, maybe as good as anybody statewide with Jeremiah and Kyrie. And then you got Robbie Clayton, Mario, Danny. I mean, the future is bright. Out of everybody come back, there's only a couple juniors that'll be seniors. Jeremiah's 9th grade, Kyrie's 10th grade, Danny's 10th grade,
right.
Ryan's 10th grade. Mark Ken, we brought him up for the state tournament. He's in the 9th grade. I really think Holbrook boys basketball has a very bright future.
Do you have any final question, Joe?
No.
All right, Mr. Gifford, thank you so much for talking with us.
That's good contact on it.
Maybe 3.
And he'll be rounding the bases. He's got 2. When he pushed for 3, you know it. And Golden, he's got a stand-up triple with great contact on that one. All right, we're here with Coach Walsh. Obviously, this guy right over here next to me pretty well. But I just want to start off, what did you think of the season this year with the group of seniors that you've had that are graduated? What did you think of their final year?
Yeah, pretty good.
few of them, I think three or four of them I've had for 4 years. The other one I had you guys for a couple of years. But they really hung together. They seemed to just, you know, gel well, and I think that was kind of the strength. We had, I think, four come from behind, walk-off wins, and I think two that we had come back in the top of the seventh and then, you know, closed out the game. So, you know, as far as that goes, yeah, I think that them being seniors really helped a lot. Just, you know, a lot of fun, too.
Oh, yeah. Was there any, any of the seniors specifically that had growth from when you first had them to the end that really stuck out to you?
Well, this guy right here, definitely. And I know Comer and Capaluco, they were with the JVs a couple of years ago. Bobby and Joey, I had, you know, from when they were freshmen.
Right.
But I think that those four kids, you know, coming up from the JVs really had no idea what to expect from them. And, you know, especially, you know, last year, first year varsity players,
right,
you know, really did very well. So.
And what, you know, a lot of guys graduating, but what's the future of Holbrook High baseball coming up?
I don't know. We had some 7th and 8th graders come up, and they did okay, and, you know, good for them.
Right. That experience will be valuable for them, I
guess. Yeah, definitely. And, you know, they seem to like the game, and, you know, that's the key. You just got to come out and play the game the right way, have fun, you know, and work hard, and I think they're going to do that. So I think it might be, you know, it's going to be a little difficult with the being, you know, younger kids, but
right,
I think, you know, if they stick with it, you know, pretty soon we'll have another group of, you know, 5-6 seniors again.
Right, it all comes full circle.
Yeah, exactly.
You have any specific questions there, Joe? For your coach?
No.
Nothing, huh? Jeez. You finished off the year really strong, though.
Absolutely.
That was really, really psyched, especially with the one-handers.
And I wanted to ask you this question. This is something Mr. Buckley and I have been talking about. He brings up to me all the time about having an athletic trainer around the school. Do you think that would, how beneficial do you think that would be to have someone, you know, if they're in a game and they're hurt, that you don't have to worry about that decision, there'd be someone else there to do it?
I coach football at Blue Hills. They have one, but each school's different. You know, it depends on the budget and what the number of kids and whatnot. You know, if you can get someone that's the same person, maybe.
Right.
But if it's just going to be someone coming in, so I guess advantages and disadvantages.
Yeah. Football, obviously, much different than baseball.
Yes,
the more,
exactly. It's
a physical sport.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, thanks so much for taking some time to talk to
us. Thanks, you guys. I haven't seen the game yet, the Blue Hills game.
It should be airing soon, I believe. We did a thing for it, and there's a play-by-play on it.
There's a play-by-play. Okay, awesome.
We'll see how good it turned out.
Right. But anyway,
good.
Yeah, thanks.
Awesome.
Thanks
thank
for your support,
you.
Guys. Thanks.
Take care. We're with Miss Gallagher. This, for starters, softball team had a very, very good season this year. Can you just talk a little bit about that and some of your favorite moments from the season?
Yeah, absolutely. We had a great season. End of the season, regular season, with a 14-4 record, second place in the league. Individual highlights of Shannon Walker, Courtney Foley, and Caroline Curtis being made Flower League All-Stars. And Courtney was named Player of the Year of the league,
which is
a huge honor. Some highlights of the season. Beat Sacred Heart in a walk-off win. Caroline Duggan scored the tying run and Courtney Foley the winning run. Swept the doubleheader against Avon. A couple shutouts against Westport. Some really big games.
So with these seniors graduating, a good group of balance, I would say. What are you going to miss most about the group that you have that are moving on?
Seniors this year, two of them have been on the team since 7th grade, which is a long time, 6 years to spend with them. So Courtney and Jim, huge roles to fill at shortstop and catcher. But all five of them were just tremendous leaders. They stepped up. They did everything that needed to be done. They all acted like captains. And they all really just fulfilled that leadership role. But they were great examples for the younger kids to follow.
When Mr. Buckley was up there talking a little bit more about younger, you know, the younger student athletes needing more time to play, as a coach and, you know, in a sport where, you know, there's only certain, you know, you can't, it's not basketball or whatever, your shortstop is shortstop, your pitchers are pitchers. What do you think of that, and do you agree with the statement about them needing more time to develop their games?
Absolutely. To have more involvement from the 7th and 8th grade, and even in the new school, it would be 6th or 8th grade, it would be a huge bonus for all the sport teams.
And talk a little bit about how the Flint Field came to be. I mean, Mr. Buckley's mentioned a little bit, but how, you know, with the construction going on, there was no home field, and that you guys were able to use that this year and have a home.
Yep. Well, on November 5th, a couple years ago, we started the conversation, where are we going to play softball? It was obviously awesome to get the building project passed, which meant we no longer had a home field. And there really wasn't a softball field in the town. The only softball field available shared the outfield with a varsity baseball field. So that wouldn't work for us either. So Mr. Buckley had the idea, and he tried to deflect the attention, but really it goes back to Mr. Buckley. He was pretty determined and worked with Little League with Mr. Bellinger, and we were able to play there. They took the mound out, and that was our home field.
And I guess for the next couple of years, it's going to keep going, correct? Until we get the new ones, one more?
And then we'll be on the new field.
Which will be, obviously, a little bit of an improvement.
Absolutely.
And final question, what's the future for the softball team coming up with all the good amount of young players?
Yeah, we did lose 5 seniors, but the girls are already talking about who's going to play where and what we'll do. Caroline Curtis pitched every inning of every game this year. She batted over 600. She's a tremendous asset to the program, and she'll continue to just improve, I think. So she'll be the leader on the team. But we have a good core coming back and a few young players on JV, and I think that looks great.
All right, thanks, Ms. Gallagher.
Thanks, Brian.
All right, we're with Coach Flanagan of the track team. We talked a little earlier at the beginning of the season. Now the season is over. So to start off, what were some of the positives you saw from your team this year?
The first and easiest one is just the numbers. We had a lot more kids this year, which is awesome. We're always looking to grow. We have like 50 kids on the team, which sounds like a lot, but we're actually still one of the smaller teams, so we're always looking to grow. Some of these teams have like over 100 people between the boys and girls, and so in order to keep up with those teams like West Bridgewater and Diamond and stuff like that, we've got to continue growing too. And we've got so many good athletes in Holbrook that it's silly that they don't do track, even though I think it's just more of a function of for a new team, relatively. People don't grow up playing track when they're in elementary school and things like that. So it's something that we're working to build in. Today, this year was a good positive step in the right direction.
What do you think of the recruitment with your team? It seems like there's been guys, you know, come in from your team recruiting other students to come and join the team.
Yeah, the guy is definitely a huge part of it. They see that people don't know what track is, and they start hearing about it from the people that do it and are having a good time with it and enjoying it. So yeah, definitely the students recruiting is a huge part of it. And it's hard because, I mean, it's a new sport. People are nervous about trying something new, but we've had some good success, ups and downs. Obviously, I've already got my targets out for next year, putting out feelers for new people. But it's tough. You don't want to take anyone away from other sports either. I'm very careful not to step on Coach Walsh or Coach Gallagher's toes.
Put it out there and let them know.
Put it out there and see what people are interested in. So. But we're obviously looking forward to having our own track one day, and that's going to be huge. People can actually see a meet. No, have you guys ever been to a track meet?
No, with the track coming.
Right, so that's the problem. So hopefully in the future, you guys will have been to a track meet, and people will know what it's about and might, think they might be interested. So.
Can you talk a little bit about the seniors that are graduating? You have a pretty decent group, some of them that have been around for a while.
No, this is my 6th year coaching Rachel Hobart, which is crazy. She and I started on this track team at the same time. So my first year, she was a 7th grader. So it's kind of amazing to have me finishing this year off with her all the way through. I'm really proud of her. She made states this year, which was an awesome, a good thrill for her to have a good way to end the year off strong. But Sarah Walsh was also huge. John Laughlin was another captain that he came to the team a little bit later, but still had a big impact. And too many to mention. I'll mention your colleague, Dylan Carroll Brown. He took down a gold medal at the league meet. So I'll mention all the rest of them at the bank. But yeah, seniors are huge, and we're looking forward to seeing what the juniors now coming up can be doing for us next year as
Absolutely.
Seniors next year.
So. All right, Ms. Flanagan, thanks for talking to us.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, guys. Good luck.
All right, that's it for us here at Sports Talk. Stay tuned for a night full of awards and presentations with the coaches and the players. You got any last words to say about baseball before we get this night started?
Well, it was really fun, and I didn't really seem that much that like upbeat around them, but I really was. And if they're watching this, I'm telling them right now that I actually was. And yeah.
There you go. All right, we'll see you soon next week on Sports Talk. Have a good weekend, everybody. See you later.
And welcome to the Holbrook Junior Senior High School Athletic Banquet. At this time, I would like to welcome Dr. DeMello, Barbara Davis, teachers, Mr. Buckley, parents, and athletes. The winter-spring athletic seasons were certainly exciting ones. We are also proud of the athletes and their outstanding accomplishments this year. 8 years ago, I joined the Boosters as a way of staying involved when my daughter entered high school. 2 years later, I jokingly said, how hard could this be? And I agreed to become the president of the Boosters. 18 banquets, 6 homecomings, 2 athletic directors, and countless games, I stand before you for the last time. It has been an interesting 8 years. We have watched the homecoming parade grow from a 10-minute parade to one now that the entire town is involved in. We have hopefully started a tradition that will last forever. The countless hours we have spent transforming the cafeteria, and most recently gym, into something extra special for students to remember forever for homecoming. The look of awe on the many faces and comments, like it's so pretty and thank you, made it all worthwhile. Although I am pretty sure most of us won't want to see a string of white Christmas lights or blue fabric for a very long time. We have also had some very successful fundraising events that have allowed us to give back to the athletic teams. We were able to purchase jerseys and hurdles for the track team, the softball team new uniforms, team bags for the soccer team, water bottles for football, and other small necessities as requested by the coaches and athletic directors. Laurie and Mike, thank you for putting up with the crazy Booster president during the months of September and October. The countless texts and requests for the crazy things like 20-foot ladders or the 50-foot extension cord or better yet, the water hose to fill the dunk tank. You both have been a joy to work with, and I will miss working with both of you. Although I still have your cell phone numbers and emails, so I may keep in touch just to shake things up. To Brothers Catering, thank you for always supplying the meals the kids love. We have tried a couple of different options for the banquet, Chinese food, pizza, sandwiches, and the infamous ice cream sundae party. But every banquet, the request is the same. Please have the salad and chicken fingers. You have certainly made an impression on the children. HCAM, Zach, and the crew, thank you for your superb job at making sure the entire town knows what great athletes we have at Holbrook High. Also, thank you for supplying us with the sound system at the banquets. You always pull through for us in a moment's notice. I would be remiss if I did not take the time to thank people who have helped me throughout the 8 years. For those of you who volunteered and helped decorate for homecoming, wrap a basket, help out at a function, thank you. Christine Golden, Shannon Kapp, thank you for always being my ticket ladies. Over the last several years, you have both ensured that tickets to homecoming or banquets were always available for purchase. Robin Foley and Stacy Carrick, you both stepped up and made sure I kept my head on straight. Stacy, you went from being my right hand to the athletic photographer. The photos that you have taken over the course of the last several years capture some of the most amazing moments. I can personally say that I am extremely grateful, as are my children, that you took this task on, voluntarily, I might add, and have done such an outstanding job. You have given the athletes of Holbrook High something they can treasure forever. Robin, who would think we would be here? Sorry. Somehow we've moved from butting heads at meetings to a great friendship. You have been such a great support to me. Whether it be fundraising, final touches for the banquet, or a catastrophe in the middle of one of our events, you've always found a way to make sure I stayed calm and we accomplished our goal. Fundraising with you is something I will never forget. Your drive and determination to make sure that what was done was beyond anyone's expectation. I am truly grateful that we have had this chance to grow our friendship, and through that, our kids have benefited tremendously. To my family, there are no words for thanks that I have for your support. I started this journey as a way to stay involved with my kids and to show them that even though they are in high school, I will still be their biggest supporter any way I can. John, we are finally here, the end of the Booster's reign. Soon you will make your final trip to the attic to bring down the buckets full of Booster stuff. No matter what I needed, you were always willing to get it for me. You've been my number one supporter over the last 8 years, and for that, I am forever grateful. I love you. With the support of all of these, have been the most rewarding, memorable, and trying times I have experienced over the last 8 years. While I miss all of this, I am hoping that the next president's adventures with the Boosters is as rewarding as mine has been. Finally, to Mrs. Curtis, who has agreed to step in as Boosters president, I wish you much luck and success. Enjoy it as the time goes by very quickly, and we'll be dropping the buckets off next week. Thank you and good luck to all the athletes in the future. And at this time, I would like to introduce Dr. DeMello to say a few words.
Good evening, everyone. I wanted to start by just mentioning this is my first athletic banquet here in Holbrook, and thrilled to be here. A lot of you may not know that I have a background in coaching myself, and I mention that because, you know, tonight is going to be about the athletes, our student athletes. But I want to pause a moment to talk about the coaches, because having spent so many years in it, I know the amount of dedication and effort it takes day in and day out. After you've put in the long day, as have the students, but you still have lessons to prepare for the next day, and you're there hour after hour after hour after school, and you're watching the students, and you're monitoring their grades and pushing them to do better, and not just on the field, but in how they act, how they represent Holbrook, how they represent themselves. And it's really nice to sit back and watch them change and grow and become leaders. And it's very rewarding, coaches, to know that you have given them the opportunity to acquire some leadership skills that will carry them for many, many years to come. And there's a lot of talk about 21st century skills, but they get the cooperation, the collaboration, the teamwork, all of those in playing athletics. So students, it's going to be about you tonight, but for 1 minute now, let's make it about the coaches. Thank you all. Mr. Bolger wanted to be here tonight and unfortunately has had something come up and he's not able to attend. So I'd like to read some words, though, that he had prepared for you. He begins with welcome. I would like to thank all the parents, coaches, and friends who are here tonight to celebrate the end of another successful year for Holbrook Athletics. Thanks to Barbara Davis for being here. Thanks to Superintendent Dr. Lally and the school committee for their continued support of the athletic programming here at the junior senior high school. And thank you to Zach Gorman and the HCAM staff for covering games and events like tonight's sports banquet. A big thanks to all of our boosters, for the parents there who have given their support throughout the year. I'd especially like to recognize, and I'd ask you to please come up, the parents of our seniors, Mrs. Comer, Mrs. Kapp, and Mrs. Foley. Please, come on up. Thank you. Continues. We had a very interesting year and a very different year for Holbrook Athletics. I would like to thank all the players, coaches, and parents for their patience this year. As you may know, many teams had to get on a bus and travel to practice. I know it was frustrating at times, but I believe we all made the best of the situation. We had 5 teams play in the MIAA tournament, and that does not even include the members of the track team that competed at the state meet. We had individual milestones reached with a 100 goal scorer in soccer and the first ever 1,000 point scorer in Holbrook girls basketball history. 3 students produced and hosted over 100 episodes of Sports Talk. We had a player of the year and a coach of the year in softball, and we also won the Sportsmanship Team Award for spring track this year. These are all good. These are all accomplishments to be very proud of as a school and as a community. But I am most proud of the efforts our athletes put in off the field. This year, the sports teams helped raise over $10,000, funding which helped support local families affected by cancer and cancer research. This is truly an amazing amount of money for a small school like ours to raise. Thank you so very much for your efforts. You should all be very, very proud. Mr. Bolger also wanted to add that Mr. Buckley has asked to say a few words tonight about athletics. He comments, I thought he covered everything at graduation, but I guess he had a few more things to say. But before I let him speak here, I want to say a few words about Mr. Buckley. I want to thank you publicly for all the help you have given to me as I have slowly tried to figure out how to be an athletic director. No one really knows all the contributions Mr. Buckley made to the athletic program. He lines the softball field for every home game. Then he runs over to the baseball field to score every baseball game. He has acted as scorer, 30-second shot clock operator, cameraman for HCAM, and any other thing I ask of him. When I need help with anything, I don't even have to call. I just look around the gym or the field and wave Mr. Buckley over and tell him what I need, and it's done. Mr. Buckley will never tell anyone this, but he is the reason we were able to use Flint Field this year for softball. He took it upon himself to go to the field every day last summer and this fall to make sure the field was meticulous so the softball team would have a home field to play on this season. Mr. Buckley, would you please come to the podium? I know he's ready to talk, but I'm still not going to let him. I would like to present you with a brand new pair of Holbrook Blue Converse All-Star. I have to take it out of the box. But also, and I feel bad that Mr. Bolger's not here, but I have to say I'm very proud to be able to do this now. I would also like to present you with the first ever Holbrook Junior Senior High School Athletics Community All-Star Award.
Before I start, I have one trivia question to ask the people over here on the left. Who is the only undefeated coach in Holbrook High School history? We'll come back to it in a minute. If you can guess the answer, you get a pizza.
Is it you?
No, I was 21-1. The reason I wanted to talk today, there's an issue that I wanted to make clear to everybody. It bothers me. You are the people who will fight for what I think is right, and that is namely more sports in Holbrook, more seventh and eighth grade involvement. When the basketball season was starting, 62 boys signed up for basketball. Coach Gifford and Coach Martin decided to have a second JV team that allowed students in grades 7 through 9 to participate. Otherwise, there would only be 12 on the varsity, 12 on the JVs. Having 12 more gave seventh graders a chance to play. Having gone to soccer games and seen our seventh and eighth graders trying to play against high school 9th, 10th, and 11th graders didn't make sense. There were girls competing as hard as they could, getting beat up by older, more experienced girls. We need to have the boys and girls learn how to play ball together against kids their own age. Mr. Bolger and Mr. Gifford were able to have this JV team of 7th to 9th graders, and they played 3 games. at no cost to the town. Mr. Gifford and Mr. Martin volunteered their time. In March, on March 19th, Mr. Bolger took five girls from Holbrook High School. They were seventh and eighth graders, and they played in the St. Joseph's tournament. There was no practice. He just had these five girls come. They had played together on the JVs, and some of them on the varsity. They went ahead and they won that tournament, making Mr. Bolger the only undefeated basketball coach in the history of Holbrook High School, and leaving him 396 victories behind Mr. Gifford. It is just my opinion that we need to have more sports at a lower level, seventh and eighth grade, intramurals down at the South School. This has been presented to the school committee. It needs your help in making it come through. Mr. Bolger took away something I wanted to say, and that was about girls softball. He has given me undue credit for the Flint Field. It was through the efforts of Ms. Gallagher and Mr. Bolger that the Flint Field actually became a reality. Ms. Gallagher kept pushing, where are we going to play? Where are we going to play? Mr. Bolger is much more politically aware than I am. I come from the old school of hammering, and Mr. Bolger was able to negotiate through all the ins and outs to make the Flint Field a reality, and he deserves the credit more than I do. Anybody can do bulwark. It takes a special person to be able to negotiate with other town officials to get what we wanted, and he did that. But the real reason, and again, Dr. DeMello has already brought it to your attention, is to the student athletes. I want to thank you for your efforts. You have to be academically eligible to play. You have to work hard. And we honor that. But you have to honor the three ladies that have made this night for 6 years. In the glory days of the 1960s, when Holbrook was the place to play sports, we did not have homecoming. We did not have banquets like this. It is through the efforts of your ladies that have just been introduced that you have this to remember. You have the photographs in the back to take with you. I wish I had photographs of my days, but we won't go into that. I think you guys and ladies need to give a standing O to our three ladies, Mrs. Coma, Mrs. Foley, and Mrs. Kapp. And the final thing I would like to just say, for those who read the Boston Globe, if you did not read the Boston Globe on Sunday, on page A11, there is a advertisement. $1,000 is being given out by the Boston Globe and Star Market for a 150 to 300 word essay on why your school should score some extra funds for your athletic programs. I would hope that the great writers here on my left and on my right would try to write a letter and submit it so we could get some more money for the athletic fund. Thank you.
Everybody ready to continue with our evening? Can we just pause, please, and give a round of applause to Mr. and Mrs. Boothby so they can hear us in the back. Fantastic meal. I enjoyed my first batch of Boothby chicken fingers. quite yummy. Now I know what all the talk was about, but actually my personal favorite is the very crispy French fries.
Oh, they're so good.
I know. That's what I'm saying. I'd like to introduce, please, Mr. Zach Gorman for some special presentations tonight.
Good evening, everybody. I'm sure you're asking, what's the HGAM guy doing up here on sports banquet night? But as Dr. DeMello alluded to a little bit earlier, along with Courtney Foley and Yusuf Zia hitting some milestones this year, HGAM had three of our volunteers hit a very large milestone as well. For those of you who don't know, we have a very long-running show called Sports Talk that is produced by Brian DeStoop, Matt DeStoop, and Joe Pransky. They hit their 100th episode earlier this year, which is a feat unmatched in Massachusetts by any other high school students. For the longevity, much like the athletes that are here tonight to be recognized, these gentlemen have been dedicated for quite a few years to hit that milestone. They show up, they put the time and the effort and the work in, just like the athletes do, to produce a very quality television show. And, you know, aside from the television show, they also spent numerous games doing play-by-play and quite colorful color for the games that you may have watched on our channels. So tonight, Dr. DeMello and Mr. Bolger gave us the opportunity to recognize them. They brought it to us and said we'd like to recognize them for their incredible feat. And so at this time, I'd like to ask Brian, Matt, and Joe to come up, if you could. And so before we have a little, a nice trophies to give them, but before I do that, I'd just like to say a few words individually about them. So they didn't know that this was happening tonight. I got them here to do an episode of Sports Talk. You may have seen them in the corner talking to some coaches, but which we will air, but this is the real reason they're here tonight. So we'll start with Mr. Pransky, Joe. When Joe started with us, very shy and quiet kid, which might be a surprise to some of you, but you know, through this show, he's grown immensely. He's become a very outspoken and opinionated young man who is going to be in the fall attending Quinnipiac, which is one of the top broadcasting schools in the country. It's one of the top five. So that speaks volumes to the young man that Joe has developed into. Next, we'll talk Matt DeStoop. He kind of fumbled his way into the show. Brian and Joe decided to do the sports talk thing, and Matt was like, "Well, if I got to sit around here while Brian does this, I might as well do something." So over the course of a couple episodes, he saw what I was doing behind the camera, and he became the go-to guy behind the glass. I don't have to do anything anymore. He walks in, he knows how to turn all the equipment on, he knows how to create all the graphics, he directs the show, produces the show from beginning to end, and it basically tells me what to do at this point. He's also going to be heading into the world of computer graphics and animation, so that's a very exciting future for him as well. And lastly is Brian. I won't say as much as he probably would say about himself, but as some of the coaches in the room here can attest to, it's not often you get a special talent that there's not really a whole lot you can do with except guide them through and be there to support them and help them in any way you can. And Brian has been that kind of guy. He, from the word jump, he was well-versed at everything he's done. True professional. It no doubt in my mind that he could walk into the real world and you know, walk onto the set of NESN or anything like that and instantly make an impact. He's spent plenty of time. He's a call-in guest for a couple of local shows. They know him by name now. They know he's going to be very eloquent when he gets on the mic and talks. So I just, again, wanted to recognize these three gentlemen for an amazing feat that has not been matched in Massachusetts, and I would be hard-pressed to see it happen again. So thank you very much, guys. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Gorman, and congratulations, guys. Next, I'd like to introduce Mr. Gifford for the basketball awards.
Before we get started with the JV2 team, I'd just like to thank the boosters for everything they've done tonight. Dr. DeMello, everything she does as principal. Mr. Bulger, who isn't here tonight, you know, he's done a tremendous job. I went through it at Avon when I was the AD there, where we didn't have fields and everything else, and we didn't even have gyms. And, it, you know, it's a schedule nightmare, and what he has to go through on a daily basis to make sure everything went off this year is incredible. Mr. Buckley, who, you know, as we all know, does so much behind the scenes. The uniforms the varsity team wears is because of Mr. Buckley. Before I get to the varsity, I'd just like to, this year, we used to have what I used to call the JV2 team, 7th, 8th grade team at Avon, and I had talked to Mr. Bulger about, you know, the worst thing there is to do in sports as a coach is to cut kids. It's just, it's the worst night there is. You know, Thursday morning, when you have to cut 30, 40, 50 kids, you just walk into school and, you know, I just feel bad, you know? So I talked to him about keeping an extra 10 or 12 7th, 8th graders. And on top of that, it being a feeder program for the future of Holbrook. And he agreed to it, and my former player, who's my JV coach, Deron Martin, and I, we kind of split duties helping, you know, he did most of the coaching. And we both worked with the kids in practice, and, you know, we went through, as Mr. Buckley said, it was amazing to see them. They didn't get to play a lot of games because of whether it's snowstorms and things like that. Hopefully next year they'll play a 10 or 12 game schedule and play against other 7th, 8th grade teams or teams that might have some 9th graders playing on the team. And it was remarkable to see how far they'd come, and then just watching them play the last two or three games, it was, you know, it was like, whoa, you know, they really, really had come a long way. So I know quite a few of them on here, but I'm just going to run through the names, and congratulations to all those kids that played on the JV2 team. Mike Blank, Patrick Colas, Dominic Costa. If you are here, just come on up. Tyler Laughlin, Kevin McGahey, Ahmad Paul, and Elijah Paul. Congratulations. Thank you. The JV team had an unbelievable schedule, unbelievable season, actually. They only lost a couple of games all year. I think one to Bishop Conley, one to Westport, and I think maybe to one to West Bridgewater. So they had an outstanding, outstanding season. Deron does a great job with them, and I'll read off their names. If you're out here, come on up. Rasai Banks-Lee, Jason Chadwell, Daryl Glover, Declan Hiltz, Noah Hobart, Wayne Lounge, and Wyatt Sprague. We went 16-4, finished in third place. Captains Bobby Belezos and Christian Lapidus, CJ, I didn't even use that name, CJ. Five seniors were Bobby, CJ, Shakespeare, Greg Pierre, Sean Johnson. One of the things we did was we ran the first coaches versus cancer night. with, and it was very successful. We did it with the girls. Hopefully next year it'll even be bigger. The all-stars were Kyrie LaPlanche and Bobby Velezos. We made the state tournament. We were a high seed. We were a top four seed. First round game, we played Upper Cape, and probably played one of the best games we played all year. We won by a whole bunch of points. And then the second game was, again, another home game, Saturday afternoon. We played a team, Cash, from Boston. And other than maybe the Dennis Yarmouth game that I filled in for Coach B a couple of years ago, it was the most fun I've had coaching basketball at Holbrook. It sounds kind of crazy that, you know, the final game we lost was you know, but coming into the game, a lot of people didn't, you know, just really didn't think we could compete. I had snuck out and saw them before to make sure what I was in for, or what we were in for, and I really thought we could compete. I had no doubt in my mind that, you know, we were as good as them. Had to play well, but we were as good as them, no matter what other people thought. And obviously, you know, we end up losing by 3 points. We're up 4 or 5 at halftime and getting some big foul trouble, and ended up fouling a whole bunch of players out. But the good part was, promise several didn't get like this, but it is what it is. There's a group of, you know, these guys over here, you know, that I was their JV coach 4 years ago, and I was their varsity coach for 3 years. We went, JV year was fine, and the two varsity years, you know, I knew what I was getting into, and I knew it was going to be some tough sledding, especially 2 years ago where we were playing East Bridgewater, Norwell, teams like that, Westport, South Sectional, things like that. And so this year, you know, we kind of got the program going the right way. And as they know, I'm not the easiest guy in the world to play for. And, you know, you can grin, it's okay. And, but they know that, you know, it comes from the heart all the time. And all I ask is we compete to the fullest every day, practice hard every day, be good people, be good students, role models. And, you know, these guys I coached, they were. And very proud of them, you know, very proud of what they've done this year, very proud of what they did in their entire careers. And they know what I think, and I just can't say enough about them. And I tried not to get like this, but I did. And so I'm going to call them up now. I am going to say one more before I start calling these guys up. One guy that he's another one of those guys. He played for me on the JV team, and then he played 2 years of varsity. And he decided, he knew, you know, it was fine with me. He played hockey his senior year. And I missed him. I was trying to find a rule that I was gonna let him come play in the state tournament game with me, but it was against MIA rules, so I couldn't get around that rule. So, but I was ready to, no matter what anybody said, if it was legal, he was gonna get to play for me. And I can't thank him enough. He was one of those guys, he was the sixth guy with those other five that, you know, I'll always remember, you know, my years said, you know, everybody said, oh, you won state championship today. Oh, well, you know, I'm all in, I'm Holbrook. And Joey Golden is one of those guys that, you know, I thank him for the 3 years that he was on with the rest of these guys and the leadership he showed every day. And thank you, Joseph. Okay, here we go. Bobby Velezos. Danny Benavides. Robbie Clayton, Mario Colas, Danny Correa, McKinley Dessen, Shakespeare Aluzma, Ryan Aluzma, Sean Johnson. Jeremiah King, Kyrie LaPlanche, CJ, Mark Ken Legentis, and Greg Pierre. Thank you very much.
Unfortunately, Coach Tozzi wasn't able to be here tonight for the girls' varsity, but in a way it's kind of good because now we get to highlight the league all-star for basketball, Danielle Mercier.
Good evening. Quite the introduction. So I'll try to make this as short as possible. I know it's going to be a long night. But like she said, Ms. Tozzi and Ms. McCarthy were not able to make tonight, so I will be saying a few words, and by a few, it's a little long for the seniors, but I have a little something to say about the JV kids, which we have one swing player, Talia. Just say that. As you know, the JV team faced a lot of obstacles being such a young team, but they pushed through and never stopped trying. Their effort does not go unnoticed. Over the past 2 years, I have watched you all grow and prosper into the team you are today. I hope that next year you guys continue to grow, and I can't wait to watch each and every one of you mature into the players I know you can be. Now on to the varsity team, close to my heart. This past season was like any other season I have played. We were able to celebrate and witness an amazing milestone for Courtney. She is the only girl in Holbrook history to score 1,000 points, and I think that just deserves a round of applause. She is honestly one of the hardest working players I have ever had the pleasure to play with, and she will be dearly missed. We were also able to have many new players join the team. We did not make the tourney this year, unlike the past 3 years, at least in my case, more for some of the other girls here, but we were able to help these new players adjust and prepare for seasons to come. We will be letting go of three crucial players this year, Courtney, Shannon, and Kayla. I have played with these girls my whole high school career, and I'm deeply saddened to see them graduate. And move on to bigger and better. I wasn't gonna cry, I didn't think I was gonna. It's going to be a long season. Okay. I will miss the bus rides, the post-game celebrations, and even the losses. I honestly don't know what I will do without you guys. I know you will all go on to do amazing things in college and all of your other future endeavors. The basketball program has lost a great amount with your departure. We can't thank you enough for the dedication you have put in for these past years, and I'm going to miss you all more than you can believe. That's it. need a tissue.
You got me crying.
Oh, okay, so now I gotta call up people now that I've composed myself. So for the JV team, we have Emma Parker, Kylie McKeon, Ariana Doring, Maya Hecklin, Brooke Diabona, and then the swings, Maddie Duncanson, Christina Quigg, Amanda McKay, Talia Ta, and Rayana Muse. So we have Talia, she can come up. And for varsity, we have Tiana Yetman, myself, Maddie Duncanson, Faina, Talia Ta, Rayana Muse, and our seniors, Courtney, Shannon, and Kayla.
Mr. Bolger could not be here for a family emergency and has given me the opportunity to make a presentation to one of the best athletes in recent memory. Her accomplishment of scoring 1,000 points has been well documented. First female, only the fifth player in Holbrook history to reach 1,000 points. You say, what does that matter? What it matters is that it sets a standard for other girls. After she scored 1,000th point, being around the school a lot, I heard two young ladies say they were going to be the next Courtney Foley. Having role models, having goals to shoot for, very important. Courtney was a workhorse for the basketball team. She was in great shape. The team was young. She did all the ball handling, passing, rebounding, stealing the ball, in addition to the scoring. She is a role model, and there is a young lady, one of those young ladies here tonight, who I hope will emulate Courtney in the future, a seventh grader, an eighth grader, that I hope will also emulate Courtney, so that the women's basketball program can move on. And we have a special award to give to Courtney. So Courtney, if you would please come. In celebration of her 1,000 points to Courtney Foley.
Congratulations, Courtney. Thanks. What I'd like to do next is introduce Ms. Maggie Gallagher, the coach for the softball team. But in doing so, I think it's important to acknowledge and recognize that she was the league coach of the year. Comes a wonderful plaque. Yeah.
I'd like to start out with a few thank yous. First, to the Boosters for hosting tonight. HCAM for covering their first softball game this year, and they did two for us. Administration, especially Dr. DeMello, she even assisted at the cookout over in Avon, even with Shannon's inquiries. In particular, Mr. Bulger, he paid such close attention to detail, especially with our home tournament game. He just made it extra special, working with HCAM, getting the sound system set up, introducing the team, really made it extra special for the girls. As always, I'd like to thank Mr. Kerr. He's not here tonight, but even with our field moving, he was still there to get the field ready for us. And of course, Mr. Buckley for all his dedication to the team and the field. I could go up there every day at my lunch and I'd see Mr. Buckley working on the field, and I knew it would be a good day. And last, for the parents, just to thank you for all your support throughout the season. For the past 2 months, I think I probably spent more time with your daughters than just about anyone. And I'd just like to thank you for raising such amazing young women. And last, Ms. McCarthy couldn't be here tonight, but I'd just like to thank her for stepping in to coach the JV team. They definitely showed a lot of improvement, and that will definitely benefit them and myself in the future. And now to the varsity team. As many of you may know, we had a pretty successful season. We finished second in the Mayflower League with a 14-4 record. A few highlights. We opened the season with a battle at Bristol Aggie, winning 18-14. We had a walk-off win over Sacred Heart, sparked by Caroline Duggan and Courtney Foley. A big win over Norfolk Aggie, two shutouts of Westport, the doubleheader sweep of Avon, and of course hosting that home tournament game, which unfortunately ended our season with a 3-2 loss. A couple of individual achievements. We had three Mayflower League All-Stars, and Caroline Curtis, Courtney Foley, and Shannon Walker. This is a second All-Star selection for Caroline. This year she pitched every inning of every game and also batted over 600 on the season. This was Shannon Walker's fourth year anchoring the infield at shortstop. This year she had a new third baseman on one side, a new second baseman on the other side, and a new left fielder behind her. So she made sure they knew what to do and kept them on track at all times. And like Caroline, Courtney was a Mayflower League All-Star last year. And last year she was also recognized by the Patriot Ledger as an All-Scholastic. This year she was recognized by the Mayflower League for both her offensive and defensive skills. And I'll come back to that later, Ms. Foley. The girls have an awful lot to be proud of for their accomplishments on the field. But before I call them up, couple other things. Back in February, Caitlin, Christina, Sarah, and I had a conversation about passions. If you've talked to Dr. DeMello, you know where that came from. And they said softball. And there were very few kids that I could think of in the past that I would say had a passion for playing softball. A few weeks into this season, though, I realized that all 13 of these girls, if someone asked them what they were passionate about, they would say playing softball. A few weeks ago, one of the younger girls on the team, on the way home, got everyone's attention on the bus. And she told them that there was no better way to spend her 13th birthday than with all of them. It was a simple comment, but it really just showed that they were a true team and came together and were passionate about what they did. Which leads me to my second point, friendship. These girls were all friends before the season started, but as the season went on, that friendship just strengthened. And they're over here crying right now, and I can attest to that. They enjoyed each moment they spent together, whether a practice, game, an ice cream sundae party, it just doesn't matter. And then leadership. Shannon and Courtney were the captains of the team. They were the ones I would go to, and they would relay messages or expectations. They handled issues that came up day in and day out. However, all five of the seniors, they gave their all during every game, and I knew all five of them were leaders. Their individual skills melded together to lead such a successful and memorable season. in these five seniors. We had the valedictorian, the salutatorian, the National Honor Society president, student council president, and the first 1,000-point scorer. It's quite a resume for five seniors. And finally, and most important, the bigger picture of the season that Dr. DeMello already touched upon. Personally, I was fortunate enough to work with Mr. Bulger and the coaches and the teams on each fundraiser this year, in the fall, the winter, and the spring. This winter, Mr. Flanning and Mr. Walsh, myself, and I had discussed different fundraising ideas we could do. However, in February, we quickly knew what we wanted to focus our fundraising efforts on. While the money we raised this season definitely exceeded the goal we set when we began, that is not what I hope all of these athletes remember. I hope more than anything else, each of you walk away from this season realizing that you can make a difference in the life of someone with something as simple as hanging purple gossamer from the lights in the hallway. Sarah and Christina summed it up nicely at graduation. Sarah said one of her favorite memories of high school was the night the team spent decorating the school purple. Sarah, I agree with you. That's one of my favorite days I've spent in Holbrook as well. And as Christina said in her speech, sometimes it's the simplest things that can mean the most. And I hope as you guys look back on the season, that's what you remember. And now I'd like to call the team up. First, our seventh graders, Kylie McKeon and Emma Curtis. Emma is our Rookie of the Year. She started in left field for us, and it was great to watch her improve over the season, but watch her in confidence increase as well. We had one eighth grader on the team, Caroline Duggan. Caroline was probably the best number nine hitter in the league. She batted over 500, and she sparked many rallies ahead of the Courtney and Shannon duo that followed her. We have two ninth graders on the team, Caitlin and Caroline. Caitlin played softball for the first time this year. She was the understudy for Sarah over at first base. She always needed to be on her toes because we never knew if Sarah might get hurt. And as I mentioned earlier, Caroline Curtis pitched every inning of every game. Additionally, she led the offensive charge, batting over 600. I just told her the story the other day of what Mr. Buckley said to me after he watched our senior game at South Shore Christian. He very calmly said that I didn't exaggerate. Caroline is really that good. The two juniors on the team, Maddie and Becky McCarthy. Oh, we skipped Savannah. I skipped Savannah. One sophomore, Savannah Barris. Savannah was new to the team this year, and she was probably the best teammate anyone on the team could have asked for. She was always cheering them on and even liked carrying the helmet bag. Two juniors, Becky McCarthy and Maddie Duncan. This year, Becky stepped in at second base, and I think everyone over here would agree that she was definitely the most improved on the team throughout the season. And last, our seniors. First, we had two managers who were unable to be here tonight, Melina Barzola and Joselie Ponce. And now, if the five of you will come up together, please. First, Sarah Carey. Sarah stepped in last year at first base for the team. She constantly had to be on her toes. You never knew when Courtney would throw the ball down there. In fact, they got three people out over at first base picking off the runners. At third base this year, we had Christina Forty. She made the move over from second base. She did a great job in the new position. She proved her versatility. She played shortstop, first base, and center field this year as well. In right field was Caitlin Tatel. Over the past 2 years combined, Caitlin probably improved the most, even though she would still be quick to tell us that it wasn't her style to use two hands when catching the ball. Caitlin went from someone who was scared to have the ball hit to her to someone who wanted the ball hit to her each and every time. And last, the two captains, Shannon and Courtney. Shannon and Courtney have both been on the team for 6 years, starting with me as seventh graders. As captains, these two provided better leadership than I would have ever imagined when the team voted for them and they were named captains back in March. Both have been on the team since seventh grade, and watching them grow and mature from then to today has truly been a pleasure. And I'd also like to recognize Courtney at this time. This year she had 9 triples, 5 home runs. She scored 39 runs in 19 games, drove in 22, had 153 career stolen bases, and this earned her the well-deserved title of Mayflower League Player of the Year. And at this time, I'm going to turn the microphone over to Caroline Curtis.
How do you fix this thing? Hold on, I gotta pull it up on my phone. Hold on a second. What do you mean when you do this? Gal, how do I like? Do I just say it? Oh. All right, I'll just go. So, it's loading. See, I did it on my phone. All right, I'm just going to wing it. So this year, the seniors have had a huge impact for all of us on the team. And next year, oh, finally, okay. They've been such incredible role models and leaders to all of us. Next year will be so different without them on the field with us. It is so sad to think that this is one of the last times that we're all going to be together as a team, but we all have plenty of memories to look back on. Shannon, Courtney, Christina, Caitlin, and Sarah, you guys have taught us so much in just a short amount of time. We are all beyond thankful for having you guys to look up to. We have all gotten so close this year, you guys became like sisters to us. We wish you all the best of luck in college and hope you come back to watch some games next year. Thank you for making it a season none of us will ever forget. See, I just got the hug. Oh. We also have a gift here to present to Mr. Buckley.
Oh, no, you still had to be. Good. Thank you.
Next, I'd like to introduce Mr. Walsh for the boys' baseball team.
I'd like to call up Mr. Capitalupo. Where is he? Another outstanding job with the JV team. A lot of young kids this year, and I actually stole a bunch of them. So we had to rearrange the schedule, which Mr. Bulger did extremely well. So at this time, Mr. Capitalupo.
Thank you. Do you have all the... Okay. Hello, everybody. Can you hear me in the back? For me to speak first, I want my JV players that I had, not the older kids that come down and help, just to come up here with me, please. Aaron, Billy, Robert, Jonathan. Just kind of hang here, okay, guys? So everybody knows, well, first off, I want to thank distinguished guests and everyone that allows me to coach every year because, like I always say, coaching is always my first love. I always love playing sports no matter what. And obviously, you get a little old, you put on a little weight, and you can't play sports anymore, so you got to coach. And I appreciate everything Everybody does me allowing me to do that and give back to Holbrook and the kids because I enjoy it more than anything. I really do. Thank you very much. This year was more trying than any of the previous four, so this is my fifth year coaching junior varsity baseball at Holbrook High. To say the least, we struggled a little. We only won one game. That one game, though, was almost perfect. We beat Westport at Westport, I believe 8-1, with two seventh graders going the distance. One pitched four innings, the other one pitched three. And that's a similar school. They have grades 7 through 11 also playing for them. But those kids, Aiden Barrett, who's not here tonight, and Robert O'Brien, who is here, have a bright baseball future no matter what high school they go to, and I hope they stay here. Very good talent for seventh graders. A lot of people don't understand that at Holbrook High. You have a unique opportunity. Being a seventh and eighth grader and playing varsity sports, that is huge. I would have given a limb when I was in high school to be able to do that, or if I was allowed to play when I was at junior high school. It's a very big and great opportunity. And even these seventh and eighth graders got actually called up to play varsity this year. It's honestly outstanding. I just hope that Mr. Walsh appreciated all the work that I tried to put in with them early enough when they got up there for when he used them. It made my season a little bit longer because of we couldn't play with, we just didn't have the numbers, but it was a real still fun season. Highlights from this year, Brian DiGiacomo's not here, so I'll talk about him first. Dropped third strike, it turned it into a triple. That's what it's marked in the book. Danny Benavides, inside the park home run, ground ball through the third baseman's leg, through the left fielder's legs, and met by Holbrook Fire at home plate with the breathing apparatus. I'm only kidding, Dan, if you're here somewhere. You're bigger than me, I know. Seriously, though, I had a lot of fun. Like I said, I enjoy teaching the kids, and I just hope the younger kids enjoyed sort of learning from me. I know I'm a little bit goofy at times, but I hope they at least learn the right way to play the game and they continue it on for maybe 5 to 6 more years. Well, at least 5, right? We don't want to stay back if we have to. I'll announce everyone that was on the team anyways. We had Aiden Barrett, who also got pulled up to varsity and actually saw a pretty significant time for varsity also. He was probably my second best pitcher, but my best hitter. I keep stats for the whole season anyways, and he was the only player out of maybe 12 players that came through that he didn't strike out one at bat the entire year. And that goes for all my older kids that come down that brag about how wonderful they are. But Aiden's not here tonight. Secondly, Danny Ben, my home run guy. Sorry, Danny can't be here tonight. Aaron Cohen. Aaron was another one of those kids that got called up to varsity. Did a great role with them, pinch running, and he has definitely improved big time from, I had him as a seventh grader also, from that last year to this year. Turned himself into a pretty good little hitter. Thank you, Aaron. The Dominator, Dominic Costa. He's not here. He struggled this year. Didn't get a hit. I feel bad for him. I tried. This next kid, you want to talk about putting a smile on someone's face.
John.
Let me read his stats. No, it's not John. Pitching stats. Tell me if this is good, if anyone knows anything about baseball. Two games on the mound, one in the third innings pitched, 13 hits given up, 19 runs, 14 of those runs earned, struck out one batter, poor kid. 8 walks. He had 0 wins and 2 losses with an earned run average of 296.96. Mr. William Curtis III. Ryan DiGiacomo also. He had the drop strike, third strike, triple. Big highlight. This next kid, I coached his brother. So I kind of thought I was getting a quiet kid that would listen to me and everything and would go along with the plan. Instead, I had someone that was a little bit too outspoken. I don't know what happened between last year and this year, but he was kind of the class clown, the team bus clown, and everything else. But honestly, he caught for me just about every game. Billy helped out a little catching also. But I think he was our best hitter, and I think he's got a bright future as a Holbrook varsity catcher someday, is Jonathan Lounge. Another player that couldn't be here tonight, Aiden McNugget McFadden. Another player that couldn't be here tonight is Zach Nassa. I think he's got a good future as first baseman here also. And then last but not least, I believe the JV player this year that has the brightest future ahead for Holbrook baseball, if he stays, which I'm really hoping he does, as a pitcher especially, I believe he's my right-handed Wayne Lounge, who I kind of groomed a little when he was in seventh grade, is Robert O'Brien. Outstanding things ahead of him, I'll tell you that right now. Other than that, I'd really like to thank Mr. Walsh this year. This was kind of a special year for me. I got to coach third base at the varsity, with the varsity team for about the last seven games, and it was really close to my heart. I'm gonna cry now, to Wiz Danielle. It was my son's last seven games at high school baseball, and it made it that much more enjoyable. But thank you very much, Mr. Walsh, for that.
Thanks, guys. Again, I'd like to thank Mr. Capitolupo. He does a great job down there. He's got a great sense of humor. You know, the kids get a love for the game, and really appreciate it. And on that, he took my thunder. I was going to mention that he had, you know, gotten a chance to come up and coach third base. And John, you'll appreciate this, probably not now, but you will a little bit down the road. I get to hang out with my dad every game. He's the scorekeeper, a.k.a. Papa Walsh. So you'll appreciate the fact that down the road, you get to hang out with your dad a little bit. I'd like to thank the Boosters for putting this on tonight and for helping out with the batting cage, which I know Declan loves. Mr. Bulger, who couldn't be here, he's just done a great job, especially, you know, with the field situation, buses and whatnot. Dr. DeMello, HCAM, they did the Blue Hills game. I haven't seen it yet. I think it's going to be on pretty soon. That was 10 innings. So if you get a chance to check that one out, it was just a great game. And Mr. Buckley, again, you know, the guys look sharp and clean and crisp because of Mr. Buckley's generous donations and, you know, his constant support. He's just Mr. Holbrook Sports, and I'd like to thank him again. We had two All-Stars this year for the Mayflower League, Joey Golden and Bobby Belizos. No clapping, sorry. Also, I'd like to thank the left field line fans. They're there all the time. Hopefully, I know some of their sons are moving on, but hopefully they'll come down and you know, watch some of the baseball. It's always a pleasure to see their support down the left field line. We gave them some excitement this year. We had four walk-off wins and two come from behind at the top of the seventh where we closed it out in the bottom of the seventh. We were able to make, fortunate enough to make the tournament for the fourth time in 4 years. So some of those, you know, seniors that I had as freshmen, that's a pretty good run. And, you know, congratulations to you guys. That's not easy to do. The seventh and eighth graders that came up, they have a new DH rule this year. Really made substituting hard as far as pinch runners, putting people in and out of the game. We were down at Westport, and I think we had 11 kids and Bobby got hurt, couldn't go in, just trying to make substitutions, this and that, and I said, this is crazy. So we called up some of the seventh and eighth graders, which meant they couldn't play games the same day. Usually they go to the opposite field. So they had to reschedule all their games to play on the days that we didn't play. So it was just chaos, but you know, they did it, and I'd like to thank them, because it's not easy coming up to play varsity sport. I know Aaron's here. I'm not sure if Billy's here. And it was just for them to get in, you know, the concentration. They really didn't want to make a mistake. They really played hard. And they, you know, and the older kids really, I think, appreciated having the little guys around. So it was good for morale and good for teamwork. So at this time, I'd like to call up the players. I know not everybody's here, but I'll just read them off. Aiden Barrett. Bobby Belizos. John Capitolupo. Aaron Cohen. Brendan Comer. Brendan's not here. William Curtis III. Billy was our first base coach, and kids really liked him. He never stopped talking out there, kept them on their toes, and he wasn't pinch running very often. So in one of the games, I look up, and there's Aaron trotting down to first base to coach first. And I said, you know, what's going on with Billy? Well, he figured if he was not coaching first, then maybe I'd put him in the run. So immediately he went back to first base. But he did get in the last game in the tournament. Seamus Galgay. Seamus did a little PowerPoint presentation on the perils of the pitching machine. He's really not a big fan of the pitching machine. And as Coach Giff had mentioned, you know, you can't say enough about you know, this year's captain. Just loves the game, great leader, always positive, just a joy to coach. I'll never forget the game down at Bishop Conley. First game, he had some comment, and I just threw him the look, and from that point on, we just had a great relationship. One of my favorite people, Joey Golden. Since Seamus doesn't like the pitching machine, Declan doesn't like the batting cage, so they'll both be setting those up next year. Noah Hobart. Noah led the team in RBIs this year. What'd you have? How many RBIs? 14. Wayne Lounge. As my friend Doty says, who's pitching today? Is Curly Sue pitching? That's she always wants to know. Aiden McFadden. Robert O'Brien, another seventh grader, came up, did a great job. And Joe One Hand Pransky. Joe did a great job in center field. Yeah, we had some seventh graders had to go out there once in a while. He covered a lot of ground. Joe, thanks. Jonathan Valeros. And Alex Westgate. So again, I'd like to thank everyone for their support. This was, you know, with this many seniors, and I'd like to thank the girls softball team for supporting us. They came down after they had just lost a tough tournament game and still came down and cheered us on at Blue Hills, and that was awesome. Thank you, guys. And I look forward to the upcoming season. We've got a couple years, we'll have some new baseball fields, new school, which is very exciting. And I'd like to welcome Mrs. Curtis to the Boosters. I'm sure she'll do a great job. And last, next year's captain, Seamus Galgay. Thanks again, appreciate it. Yeah, guys. No.
Hey, I hope you know Seamus Galgay, team starter, pitching machine.
So before we move on to track, I want to take a moment because this is the winter and spring sports banquet.
And as I'm guessing most of you out there know, that for hockey, for ice hockey, we have a co-op with Avon and Blue Hills. And so we only have two players on the team, but we would be remiss if we didn't acknowledge them. And in particular, so the two players, as you know, are Brendan Comer and Joey Golden. But what some of you don't know, well, because you were in the thing, so come up on the screen. What you may not know, though, and I'm glad Joey's up here, is he won the Hobie Baker Character Award, which is awarded... It's an award that's given out every year in ice hockey for athletic integrity, positive attitude, coachability, outstanding sportsmanship, and community spirit. And I will tell you that many of you who are out there will someday coach. And boy, those are the characteristics that you're looking for in an athlete. So congratulations. Next, I'd like to call Andrew Flanagan up.
First off, I'd like to start with thank yous. Thank you to all of you for being here. Thank you for the boosters for putting this together every year. It seems like it gets better and better, and it's great to see this room so full. Thanks to Mike Bulger, the athletic director, always helping us out and supporting us. Getting us two buses this year was great. One big thing, I think everyone can agree. All the parents, thank you so much for all your support. Couldn't do it, obviously, without you. Irma Ferroyo, the nurse, and Betsy Eaton both couldn't be here, but did a lot of work with our team this year, helping us out with coaching whenever they could on a volunteer basis. Nurse Ferroyo led our team in some yoga exercises here and there, which was great, working on the flexibility. So appreciate all that they've done. The other coaches, thank you for having such a great relationship, all three of us together. I really appreciate what we can all do together, especially what we did this spring with the shirts and everything like that. And Dr. DeMello as well. Thank you for all your support through everything, and it's been a fun season coaching with all the support from everybody. So thank you for all that. I'm going to start with my certificates and get my team up and acknowledge all of you folks first, because I do want to make sure the focus is on you folks and have you up here with me while I'm talking about some of the things that you accomplished this year. So I'm just going to go through the names, and I'm going to call everyone's name even if they're not here, just to make sure. Okay. So first, let's start off with Lucy Ambrolt. Martina Guzma. Rasai Banks-Lee. Dylan Carroll Brown. Charlanda Cologne. Nahida Content. Frederick Quamon. Sorry, Paula. Sean Crosby. Christian Esperon. Fina Etienne. Aaron Fadragalan. Nick Fanfan. Joe Gallant. Chris Greeley. Rachel Hobart. Chantal Infante. Sean Johnson, Carla Joseph, Chris Kamau, Aiden Kelly, Jess Kierzik, Jen Kierzik, both of you come on up, Josh Kiss, CJ Lapidez, Tyler Laughlin, and John Laughlin, Madison Mann, Haley Manning, Cameron Marshall, Danielle Mercier, Janaea Morriso, Matt Mullen, Amy Nguyen, Destiny O'Garo, Devin O'Garo, Sasha Oliveira, Nick Polano, Cashley Reyes, Nick Ripley, Julian Romero, Sarah Ryan, Jermall Sinvillis, Finbar Sheehan, Ethan Sprague, Sean Steinberg, Mariana Tehran, and Sarah Walsh, and Tiana Yeb. I had it right here. I thought Walsh was the last one. Come on. Thank you. So that was a long way of saying my first point, which one of the first things that I wanted to highlight about this team this year, this is easily the biggest team I've ever had, which is in track and field, it's really important. You would be surprised to know this is still a small team in our league. We are still a lot smaller than some of the other folks, despite all the names that I read off. So it's huge that we're continuing to grow, and I really appreciate that these kids are the outgrowth, and some of them have been around when we were really just a couple of us. It really wasn't much more than a handful in some of the early years. And so it's a testament to these folks that they've stuck with it and developed this program despite some of the challenges, not having really more than, I don't even know what the square footage of our practice space behind the school would be, but we're trying to squeeze in javelin throws between bulldozers, it seems like. So. It's been a bit of a challenge, but these folks all really stuck with it despite all the challenges. They would jog over to Sumner Field with me, jog back, throw and jump wherever I could get them. So I really appreciate all of the persistence from everyone, and I hope we can keep growing. So we want more people. So everyone, come on out for the team. Absolutely, we want more people. So a couple things I wanted to highlight aside from that. First off, I think the girls' team deserves, as a group, recognition for coming in third place in our league meet, which is our championship, basically, at the end of the year for the Mayflower League. So third place out of nine teams is a pretty big accomplishment when we're going up against the Volk schools and all the big folks there. So congratulations to the girls' team on that accomplishment. Second year in a row, actually, I should mention. 2 years in a row, third place in the league, showing some real staying power and consistency and growth to really stay up there at the top, near the top end of the league, which is really great. Next, I'd like to mention a few school records team records, as Coach Gal will always make sure I'm very clear. I'm still waiting, we're working with Mr. Buckley to make sure we can actually get the real school records back from the 60s and 70s. It's not there yet, but so these are my team records and some of the highlights of the years for the performances that we've had. So when I call your name, just stand forward if you're here just to be recognized. Nick Ripley in the javelin, Nick Fanfan in shot put, Aiden Sprague in the mile, beating his brother's record from last year. I'm sorry, Aiden was a record that was broken. It's Ethan that broke the record. Excuse me, I'm getting my Sprague's mixed up. Sarah Walsh and Discus, the girls 4x1 team of Martine, Lucy, Destiny, and Madison, putting up an amazing time at States this year. Destiny taking down the 100 and the 200 herself individually, which is great. And Martine taking down triple jump and 400 meter hurdles. So we had a lot of really, really high level performances this year. And that really shows how much we're progressing as a team. So congratulations to all you folks. Next, I will talk about states. For those of you that don't know, teams don't qualify for the state tournament in track and field. Individual athletes qualify on their own, and then that forms your team at the championship meet. So each one of these folks has a certain level that they have to perform at in order to qualify for this meet. And so this is really one of the big benchmarks that we have in track and field for them to really strive for and try to achieve. And this year, I'm proud to say that we had the most kids ever since I've been coaching in my 6 years here qualify for states, having 9 people qualify, which I think is interesting enough for a baseball or softball team. So maybe we can, I don't know if that would go very well for us against those tournament qualifiers over there. But still proud of these folks. I'm just going to list them off for our state's qualifiers. So that was Nick Ripley again, Sarah Walsh, Rachel Hobart, Cam Marshall, Destiny Ogero, Madison Mann, Danielle Mercier, Martine Albusma, and Lucy Ambrose. So, congratulations, you guys. One more thing before I move on, I just want to recognize this guy next to me. His season actually didn't end until Tuesday. We were actually down in Attleboro at the MSTCA Decathlon, which is 10 events, in the rain. Yeah, that's right. We got delayed a little bit. Got home late on Tuesday because of a thunderstorm. But he just did 10 events over 2 days, which is a huge feat of stamina, endurance, and skill. And he's the only guy I've ever had do it 2 years in a row. I've had some people do it once, and then they're done with it after that. But Ripley liked it, and it has the heart and the drive to keep going through things that are difficult. He likes things that are difficult, which you really need to in order to excel in order to these things. Maybe school we could work on a little bit, but we'll get there. So congratulations, Nick, on doing that. I'd like to recognize the seniors. We had a great bunch of seniors this year that really contributed, and some of them have been on the team for a really long time. Some of them are new to us, but however they came to us, we're really glad to have had them, and just want to make sure we recognize all of them, too. So first, I'd like to call up CJ, Christian Lapidus. Sean Johnson. Dylan Carroll Brown. I'd like to note while Dylan's up here, took a gold medal, first place league champion in the 100-meter hurdles, 110-meter hurdles. Huge accomplishment. Josh Kiss. One of our most solid performers in discus for several years now. Amy Nguyen, I'm not sure if she's here. John Laughlin. I should say I'm getting to my captains now, so I'm gonna start naming my captains. Nick Ripley was one of my captains as an underclassman, but for John Laughlin as a senior captain, I really appreciate all the work that he did in setting a good tone for our team. Next we have Rachel Hobart. Rachel has the distinction of having been on the team for 6 years with me. She started in seventh grade. That was my first year coaching, so she's been on the team longer than anyone else ever, and it's been really an honor and a pleasure to have coached her all these years. And lastly, but not least, Sarah Walsh. I do want to point out that, especially after naming those senior captains, this goes to everyone, but Sarah and Rachel deserve a lot of credit for this. And this is something that I'm probably most proud of, one of the most, the biggest accomplishments that I've had my athletes achieve in a season. And Dr. DeMille mentioned it earlier, but the Sportsmanship Award for the girls track team is really something that I'm very, very proud of these folks for accomplishing. It's something that we made a point of highlighting and really focusing on this year. And Sarah and Rachel and everyone, but those two in particular, really took that to heart and made that a goal and basically a way of life for us. That was something that we made a point of really exemplifying in all facets of the game, all facets of the interactions we had with other players, other coaches, the officials, and I'm really proud that they got the chance to be recognized for that, because it was really something that I'm very proud of for them accomplishing. So another round of applause. And I do want to mention that was for the girls team, but you cannot separate these two teams. It's one thing that I love about coaching track is that I get to work with both of them together. Even though they have separate records and separate awards and separate a lot of things, they're really one team, and more so this year than any other year. So congratulations to all of you. That was really a big accomplishment. I think that's it. Thank you very much.
So that about wraps up our evening this evening for this athletic banquet.
But we're not going to let her finish. So just to take 2 seconds, just to say thank you one last time, not only to Peg as being the president, but also John for kind of being the first lady. As much as Peg has done, John has been like there every step of the way. He's there every meeting. He's at every event that we have. He literally lugs everything out of the car. He'll put dozens and dozens of balloons. Guy can put more balloons in a car than anyone you've ever seen. It's insane. He really, truly, along with Peg, has done so much for the school and so much for these kids. So this is a small token of appreciation to you and John to say thank you guys for all you've done. And we welcome Christine as a new president and her new first lady, Bill.
Okay, so with that being said, for the last time, I will say thank you all for coming and hope you enjoyed the evening. I will not see you in the fall. Maybe. But good luck to all the athletes, good luck to all the families, and please, 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 for those families of the younger athletes, it's a very small commitment to help with the boosters. We do two fundraisers a year, three banquets, and homecoming, and that's it. We're not a high-intense group. We're very low-key, but we do need your help. So please consider helping Mrs. Curtis, because this is a huge undertaking for one person, because all of us that are on the board currently are now finished. She's it. So please step up. Hey, great. Have a good night.